along there from Fairground Attraction.
You've got to be careful of those kisses. You could have a thousand, you could have a million. But, ladies and gentlemen, I know you're saying to yourself, where's the number one song?
They're saying, where is the number one song?
It'll be coming along very shortly, but right now, let's talk about the Saturday Morning Live Pack. These are getting very popular.
Very, very popular indeed.
Every week, we give away three of the Saturday Morning Live Packs. They contain heaps of goodies, including the top 10 albums. And you may notice a little thing in here. I'll just see if we have
Dano's just displaying the top 10
These
albums.
These are the top 10 albums, by the way.
He's doing a beautiful display job.
At least look, at the end, Whispering Jack.
Oh, that's
back
right.
In the top 10 albums.
Good on you, John, because not only does Age of Reason is a number, but it's Whispering Jack's back in there. And also, it looks like Whispering Jack may be getting re-released.
There's a girl behind us. Look. She could suddenly go country and western with that hat.
You're the voice.
We're also giving this away with these Saturday Morning Live Pack, the T-shirt, and a couple of tickets to a great new movie called Beetlejuice.
Can I just mention, Dan, that You're the Voice is being played on American radio?
You're joking.
No, they're going, hey, this John Farnham guy, where has he been all our lives?
Well, that's fantastic, and it's a great pack we're giving away this week. It's chock-a-block full of fun.
It's that we're going to give away some tickets to Beetlejuice for you and your friends, a whole busload.
Shall we draw this week's lucky winners,
yes,
John?
Yes, Dan,
let me just spin this old barrel. Kylie, albums too, if you would. Thanks. Oh, thanks a lot, Kyla. Here we go.
They were just covers.
Here
Don't
we go.
Worry.
Let's draw the three winners out of
There's
here.
There's a
John.
Poor props guy down there going.
Okay.
It's
First
one.
Up. Yes, number one.
Kathy.
Right. Christina Mayer from Davenport in Tasmania. Beauty.
Okay.
Oh, I love this sort of retail stuff.
Belrose.
Jason Wilson from Belrose in New South Wales
Let's
is also a winner.
Australia.
What's the
Let's
last
Western,
winner, John?
Western Australian.
Isn't that amazing?
Australia.
Dawn
from Greenwood in WA. Good on you.
They're
Come
having
on.
A bit of a clean-up from WA. They had some major storms there last night.
We're a bit short on people from South Australia. So if you're in Adelaide and you're watching the show, send in your entries to the Saturday Morning Live
That's
Pack.
That's right. If you'd like to win one of these packs, all you've got to do is send in an envelope with the name of the current number one single, your name, age, address, and phone number on the back of the envelope. On the front, address it to Saturday Morning Live Pack Competition, Post Office Box 51, Epping, New South Wales, 2121. And you could be in the running
it's
for
so
this
easy.
Fantastic pack.
The number one record right around Australia.
We're using all these retail cliches today, aren't we?
It's not all. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, it reminds me, our number one record, of course.
It was a balmy night in July at Expo, wasn't it,
And
John?
I was standing there on the stage with 25,000 people behind me. And it's you like know, a sort of dream sequence.
We're sort of going into our first dream sequence on the program. It's a good feeling, isn't
what
it?
What a night it was.
It was
just like
night.
Yesterday. I
yeah.
was standing
Ripple
there.
Ripple dissolved now.
John said, Johnny, get out there and kill him, mate.
No, he said, get out of the way.
He said, get out of the way, get out there and kill him. Oh, Barnum, what a night.
Went and did Age of Reason.
I think that's enough dream sequence. Thanks,
yeah,
Peter.
Yeah, thanks. I've had enough.
Ah, boy.
Sometimes for bad. shoulder, people.
Happy birthday to Neil Clugston, who had a big hand in everything to do with Farnham.
Oh, that was a great night. Expo, John Farnham Live.
What do you mean we look like idiots with this hat on?
Sorry.
Are we back?
Are we on?
Welcome back
to Saturday Morning Live. And John, I believe you've got a bit of stuff for us.
I got the clipboard. I'm a rock and roll
guru. I know you are.
You know, Australia's own Olivia Newton-John is back in the news again with a new single, The Rumour, and a brand new direction in her career. Our LA showbiz reporter, a beautiful person, Donna. We love you, Mickle-John.
Donna Mickle-John. What can I say about her? Donna Spud Mickle-John. I could have a whole rave here, but I won't go into it now. She's just a wonderful,
you're digging
warm
a hole
human being.
And you're jumping
That's
into
right,
it.
That's right, I'm jumping
into it. Well, Donna Mickle-John was packed off to the gala opening launch of the album.
Oh, by the way, did I tell you there's a special coming out with Olivia Newton-John in September on this network?
The Australian Television Network.
That's right.
And we'll be hosting it?
Like
the Farnham one?
We're working on it. With Donna Spud Mickle-John.
I'll make a call.
Thank you very much.
Anyway, Donna Mickle-John was packed off to the opening. Thank you very much. The launch of the album to tackle Livy about the new, more mature, less girly image she's launching.
Yeah, it's pretty cold here, isn't it?
Yeah, but it's worth it. Mums and dads, boys and girls, you're probably wondering why we're standing on this look-alike Hawaiian beach. But we've got some great news for you.
Yeah, in Hawaii at the moment, the weather's just beautiful. We're giving you the opportunity to go to Hawaii and see a fabulous band.
Yeah, you're going to go and see NXS, you and a friend. That's two people. Go to Hawaii, stay in a fabulous, plush, luxurious hotel. You have $1,000 spending money.
That's right, plus you get an opportunity to see the band and actually possibly meet them afterwards. We're working on
it.
Feels like very tactile.
But first, here's something to wet your whistle. So get you started. To get the juices running. Take a look at this incredible footage of Hawaii.
Thanks, guys. If you're lucky enough to win this fabulous competition, we'll fly you and your friend to the beautiful balmy beaches of sun-drenched Hawaii, where you can personally inspect this blissful isle. But don't wait. There's more. You get to see In Excess play live and maybe even get to meet the band. And we'll give you 1,000 glorious Australian dollars. Don't wait. That's all. Thanks to those fabulous people at Jet Set Tours and the wonderful folks at Air New Zealand. Is that me at the window? Now back to the boys on the beach.
Oh, g'day. Welcome back to the footage. Wasn't it mouth-watering?
Lovely helicopter shots on that one.
Well, last week we gave you this clue.
Pretty quick,
yeah. And you had to name that band. Well, this week you have to name the three brothers.
Yeah. Clue number two.
In excess. This is clue number two, and there's three brothers.
And it's not Merle Coe and Curly Moe and Shemp.
Yeah.
Or,
so you have to get anyway, you have to get that clue. And don't forget, next week there'll be another clue. And don't forget, $1,000 plus a Hawaii trip. Amazing.
It's hard to do these voices for a long time.
It is very hard. Yeah. But anyway, here's In Excess and Never Tear Us Apart.
It's reminiscent of This Will Be an Everlasting Love. And of course, that is the new one from Natalie Cole, Everlasting. What more can I say? The crew were enraptured with that one. You loved it, guys?
Goodness me, the coffee's arrived, I think, actually, John.
That Mitchell's coffee hasn't arrived. I'm worried.
You know, I'm very excited at the moment, John. You may know by the hat I'm wearing at the moment.
Scary.
Because James Brown has suddenly come back and answered his critics. James Brown's an angry man. Ask his wife. She was in the car when he was shooting at it. But he's angry.
And he was going, I feel good.
I feel good. Blam. But a lot of people have been sampling James Brown's older clips.
That's where they steal little bits out of his records and put them in things like Pump Up the Volume and
Paid in Full. Oh, a whole bunch of other stuff. That's as many as we can remember at the moment.
He's back.
But, you know, James is very angry.
I'm very angry.
I feel good.
And he's put out a brand new clip. James Brown with full force. And
I'm real.
I'm not sampled. I'm real on Saturday Morning Live. Get out of bed.
Woo!
Okay, we're on. Okay,
that was Mission Impossible.
Good morning, I'm Jono.
And I'm Dano. Welcome to the Off the Record Music News.
It's not the same, we had to explain what theme it was.
No, it's not really.
Right, Vivaldi next
little
week.
Little cards next week.
First story, Dan. Former Beatle Paul McCartney has cut short his summer holiday to slam a new book called The Lives of John Lennon, and he's asked the public to boycott the book, describing it as a piece of trash.
Good on him!
McCartney's anger mainly stems from a section of the tome that alleges that the late John Lennon was a homosexual close to madness. I thought madness was a band.
Yeah, it's rubbish. I don't know. I don't like the people saying that about John Lennon.
No. Anyway, McCartney rebuffed that statement, describing Lennon as no more than just a wild and wacky guy.
Which he was.
Exactly.
Australian folk hero and Expo legend John Farnham has announced he'll be doing a gig in Beijing, China soon.
Oh, yeah.
With unbridled enthusiasm, John's chief spruiker, Glenn Wheatley, wonderful guy, isn't he, visited the People's Republic this week and talked the Chinese officials into allowing the concert. And, of course, there'll be catering. If that's not enough to leave the Farnham camp in a state of ecstasy, John's debut album, Whispering Jack, has reappeared at number 10 on the national charts. And, of course, Age of Reason, the album and single, are at number one. I remember that night, don't you?
Oh, that Expo night. I tell you what, it was just
July, wasn't it?
25,000 people night. And...
No, hang on a sec. They're going back into
the... dream sequence.
Forget
no more
dream sequence.
Okay, we're in the news, off the record news, Jono and Dano. Over the past weeks, four new FM radio licences have been granted in regional Australia.
Oh, Lord.
Two in Victoria and one each in New South Wales and Queensland.
Oh.
Now the government has actually announced that each major capital city will get four brand new licences. Count them, folks. Not three, not two, but four brand new FM licences in each capital. There'll be two AM stations which will be allowed to convert to FM at great expense, of course. And while the remaining two FM stations, the licences will be auctioned to the highest bidder.
Oh, really?
I mean, big bucks. Well, let's hope those brand new FM stations play a little bit more new Australian music and new music in general.
Oh, very well said. Small
thank you very much. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Yes, Joe Camilleri and the Black Sorrows are all important.
Written and authorised by Joe Camilleri.
Thank you very much.
In June, Richard Clapton married Susie Rain in Paris. It's a beautiful thing. Because of the far-flung location, few of his pals could attend. So Richard organised a second wedding reception in Australia. I was invited but didn't turn up. Sorry about that, Ralph. But
you wanted to go, though.
I wanted to go.
You forgot.
I don't know what happened. Oh. But Jono and our producer attended to ogle at the assembled luminaries and scoff the odd party sausage roll.
That was great fun.
Out of the multitude of congratulatory backslapping, an impromptu band emerged where Jimmy Barnes captured the light and easy hearts by doing a version of When a Man Loves a Woman.
It was amazing. It was like a who's who of rock and roll buddies. There was Kevin Borridge playing really loud guitar.
Yeah.
Mark Callahan, some of the Stetsons. John Stevens from Noiseworks got up and did some singing.
Oh, really?
And then we all had a big fist fight in the foyer of the Siebel. It was great. No, just kidding. But it was a great night. And best of luck to Richard.
Good on you, Ralph.
Child bride.
Nice thing, isn't it?
Beautiful.
Is this my next story?
Yes, it
am
is.
Am I doing two stories?
Two stories. Go for your life.
Am I getting paid?
Excellent.
Okay. Last week, we reported that a U.S. radio executive was putting up $2 million for anyone who could trap Elvis and deliver him to his radio station. We took up the challenge, and here's the result of our bid to catch Elvis and claim the $2 million reward.
Very close.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, fellow family pets, this is it. The Mark 1 Coleman Elvis catching trap.
I don't know, and how? What's the principle behind it?
Let me run you through it. Come in here, Neil. Look. You see, Elvis Presley loved watching television.
Yeah.
This is one of the fine,
Do you think Probe is the sort of program he wants to see?
We've got Probe. We've got a continuous loop of Probe and Darren Hicks.
Yeah, right.
He's coming in. He smells the hamburger, first of all. There's the hamburger there.
Yeah.
He leans back in his easy armchair and notices and smells that beautiful, fresh hamburger from the Channel 7 canteen.
Oh, no.
And as soon as the pressure is changed, he lifts up the hamburger through a system of weights and pulleys. This rope, the pressure changed on it, the tension changes, and then before he knows it, he's enveloped in the net, and the $2 million Australian is ours.
Well, I don't know. I like the $2 million. I'm just not sure about this trap.
Trust me. Okay. This way. Come
okay.
On.
This one.
I just
remember
like
when we tried to trap Delilah a couple of years
ago. I'm really starting to lose my patience.
No.
An hour and a half. I've got a pressing dental engagement to get to.
Yeah. Look, just trust me, mate, because I believe that Elvis will turn.
What?
Why?
Just behind the tree.
Up there.
He's omnipresent.
Mate. Viva
Las Vegas. Settle down. Let the Coleman Mark 1 do its work.
It will, mate. It will not let us down. As I've got
okay.
supreme confidence.
Yes, it's working.
Oh, this is working perfectly, is it?
He's Las Vegas. Viva
What happened to the Coleman Mark 1?
Mate, it's a tiny little timing adjustment. It's just a little adjustment.
Timing adjustment.
I mean, he came in. He was attracted by the television.
He didn't even sit down. He went around the side and picked the hamburger up.
Well, okay, that was a small little mistake I made. But I mean, if he'd been here, he would have been watching Darren. He would have reached for the hamburger and then whammo, like that. It would have just fallen down. I mean, it's just a timing thing, Dan. Next time we'll get him.
I think you need a small adjustment. You know that, John?
Maybe
I really do.
Maybe another great idea. $2 million up the wall. I can't believe it.
Oh, yes. Choice homemade comedy there.
You know, they're getting Wonderworld back together again.
Yes, those old Warner Brothers cartoon gang.
And now it's time on the Off the Record News for the news in briefs. It's amazing what rock stars get up to, ladies and gentlemen. Overseas sources say to them, haven't they? Overseas sources say on their last holiday, New Order got up to some pretty wacky things. They ran nude along a beach, smashed hire cars, knocked down fences, and played table tennis. Absolutely stalkers!
What, they bared their bodies?
Yes!
Oh my goodness. Save your pennies. Heaps of big acts are on the way. Over the ensuing months, we're going to expect Joan Armour Trading, Bross, Def Leppard, INXS, Sting, Terence Trent D'Arby, and that's not all. Also, Brian Ferry,
Mick Jagger,
and even Michael Jackson. Plus, I should mention, of course, Crowded House are touring at the moment. They're fine. Get out and check them out. Thanks very much.
And also the Black Sorrows, though.
Black Sorrows.
Heaps of great music. Go and see some of that homegrown Aussie music. Following the cancellation of the Megadeth tour, I know everyone out there in TV land's going, oh, no. Megadeth tour, yes. You punters who bought tickets and you're still holding your tickets going, when's the concert going to be on again? Well, you should take those tickets back to the place where you bought them and they'll give you money back.
Could you imagine telling a Megadeth fan that the concert's been cancelled?
They'll say, yeah, but when's it starting then?
Sorry. Struth. Last month, Kylie Minogue made over $1 million, but a grueling schedule has affected her weight. It's dropped to 28 kilos, about as much as a heavy poodle.
Well, I think on going rates, I'm about four heavy poodles at the moment. Okay, Big Audio Dynamite have had to cancel their current UK tour because Mick Jones has caught chicken pox, which is pretty unglamorous.
The swelling and the,
I've had one, but not the other.
Okay, according to current rumours, Rose Tattoo are getting back together again.
Fantastic.
Goodness me, listen to that audience.
Yeah, the incredible vibe here. Dolly Parton's sister Stella has signed a new record contract, but Stella has suffered in the past when it came to shooting shots for her album cover that apparently parts of her upper region are having to be airbrushed in, especially to match the size of Dolly's things, because you see Stella is rather small. She's a small girl.
Susie Sue from the Banshees, despite constant denials, has had the cellulite sucked from her cheeks.
Maybe she could talk to Stella.
With an eye for a quick buck, memorabilia shop owners are selling the sucked out gunge as souvenirs. Yuck. Right now, speaking of sucked out guns, here's Clem Peckerhead with a rock and roll country and western weather.
They Yeehaw! Sucked it. Oh, horrible. Gunge.
We're having a double shot weekend. Howdy, partners. It's your old country cousin, Clem Peckerhead, here with a rootin' tootin' electrocutin' weekend rock and roll weather update, review, final lecture type of thing right here. Yes, sirree. Grab your shooting irons if you're in Expo City. Good old Brizzy. It's them gyrating polecats, the psychedelia, the lime spiders. Sure tastes good with some hot beans, strong coffee. Last time I didn't do that, didn't sleep for days. Okay, there it is, Brizzy. Okay, all you yuppies down there in Sydney, it's them funky fruits and kings of the square dance circuit, the rock melons. Those guys give me the pip. I said they give me the pip, rock melon. Okay, hold it down, melonhead. Anyway, put down that six-shooter and drop your chaps. We're setting a spell in good old Melbourne. Where is it? There it is. Ah, dearie dear. It's the new frontier, yep. Circle those wagons in Chapel Street. Reach for your red eye. It's time to beat those war drums with those popular porkers, Big Pig. Wonder if Horse Cartwright's joined the band yet. Okay, Corral, it's down to Hobart. Can you see it there? Yes, sirree. You can slip your boots off tonight and enjoy some of Miss Kitty's own style of hospitality and relax with Max. He's the guy with the shotgun behind me. But hold on to your britches, folks. In Grand Prix City, Adelaide, it's them yellow-bellied outlaws of bluegrass, that lily-livered larrikin with his band of bushwhackers. You guessed it, Snakey and the Rattlers. Whatever you do, ladies, don't try and stroke Snakey. You could get bit. Happened to me once. Okay, now the promised land. Here it is, the promised land. The last frontier. Yep, from Netherlands to Bunbury on the back of a mule with bad breath and flatulence. It's a big night to hoe down with the Jets. Last time I tried to hoe down, I never got up again. This is Clem Preckerhead saying, go easy, go slow. So long, you can't get over it. So long, you can't get around it. Bye-bye. Stop that, flicker.
You had to go for the Hoss Cartwright gag, didn't you?
Clem, thank you so much for joining us.
Didn't have enough trouble.
Clem Peckerhead over at the Weather Wall. And don't forget, after the next break, we have a Clive Robertson thing.
Very true, and lots of great music coming your way. So we'll be right back after these words.
And the Black Sorrows, live in the studio. All that and more. No.
Howdy, partners. Welcome back to Saturday Morning Live right around the country. My name's Jono. This is Dano over here taking it a little slow.
Hey, partners.
Now it's time on Saturday Morning Live to turn our attention to country music. And country music's brightest young star would have to be Katie Lang from beautiful Canada. If you've ever been able to bear a bit of country music, then you ought to really listen to Katie's brand new album called Shadowland. It's an absolute gas. I caught up with Katie earlier this week and began by asking her about the popular country expression, torch and twang.
Well, torch and twang is a phrase that I coined to describe my music, which incorporates torch music, which is the early style ballad singing brought from the jazz tradition, which uses very powerful approach to singing ballads. And twang is, of course, the good old guitar sound of country music.
And the first album, Angel with a Lariat, that was basically produced by Dave Edmonds from Rockpile in England. How did you get together with Dave Edmonds?
It was basically on suggestion of the record company because he had worked with people like Johnny Cash and Carl Perkins in the Memphis sort of sun sound, and also some rockabilly, and it was very interested in country also.
What kind of things do people get to see if they go and see Katie Lang in the Recline? What kind of a show do they see?
It's kind of hard for me to be objective about it and remove myself from it. I would have to say it's quite energetic. The musical style is very versatile. But there is quite a few polkas and quite a bit of country music. It's, you know, my number one passion. But the unexpected can happen. It's quite a spontaneous show and a lot of dancing.
Now, Katie, do you think that people like Weird Al Yankovic have brought down the tradition of the polka, or do you like the sort of publicity that Weird Al's been getting for polka music?
Well, I think it's great. I think polka music should be reckoned with again.
What's your favorite saying about polka again?
My favorite saying about polka?
Yeah.
To dance is human, but to polka is divine.
Katie, for all our Saturday Morning Live viewers right around Australia, where do you think you'll be in, say, 5 years' time?
The moon.
The moon. Polkering on the moon.
Yes, I'm going to open up a honky-tonk saloon on the moon.
Rockin' hard.
Hey, that's like they used to say on Play School, wasn't it? There's a bear in the air.
And people down there. Wasn't that the tackiest looking clip you've ever seen, John?
And it was shot by...
We won't say now. He won't admit to it, but that was C.W. McCall. That song sold 2 million copies worldwide. Convoy. It went to number one in the US and number two in the UK. And you know, nobody would admit to actually buying that single.
Oh, come on back.
Come on,
you
back,
know,
baby.
C.W. Call wasn't actually his real name. His real name was Bill Fries. Did you get your fries?
Oh, thank you so much.
And he was an advertising executive who did a jingle with a character called C.W. McCall in the actual commercial. And when he became a singer, Bill Fries decided to adopt the name of the character, C.W. McCall.
Yeah.
And he was very successful, of course, and he just disappeared like that. He's probably got his own advertising agency with John Singleton.
Probably
now.
An early Stock Aitken and Waterman there.
Yeah, it's very early.
In 1976, after 13 years marriage, Andrew Peacock announced he was leaving Susan Renouf. Funny how history repeats itself, isn't it, John?
Yes, and now, of course, Susan Renouf has changed her name to C.W. McCall as well.
Of course, come on back, good buddy.
Someone else who's not called C.W. McCall is Patti Smith.
Oh, she's got a fantastic new album, and this is the song of it, People Have the Power.
It's a fantastic song. It's going to be number one.
I think very close to it. Welcome back to Saturday Morning Live. You know, in earlier episodes of Saturday Morning Live, we featured a segment called Station of the Week.
Oh, fine segment.
It was a good segment. That's when we paid homage to one network station each week. You might have thought we'd forgotten about this segment, and you're probably right.
No, we didn't forget about it.
Well,
we enjoyed it.
Well, we discovered a furphy.
In fact, I discovered a furphy. I'd like to apologise to the whole furphy family. They live at Furphy's Paradise.
I used to be a furphy at one stage. You had my little furf wagon.
Body furphy.
You know, Ian Turpie used to be a furphy.
I think we've milked
it
enough.
Okay. But, however, one station had not been featured.
Which station? ATN Channel 7 in Sydney, wherever that is. So to rectify this oversight, we commissioned a newsreader and guru, sort of like a father figure, a grandfather figure to all of us,
now.
Clive Robertson, to take us on a tour of the pinnacle of television broadcasting. Clive?
Well, John, I'm very excited. Station of the Week, and of course, our feature compare for Station of the Week this week, Clive Robertson.
Come on. Clive, what's it really like working at Channel 7? I mean, is it really as glamorous as people reckon being on television?
It's like being on Commonwealth Repat. I mean, without the social life.
Do you like going to the canteen? What do you think?
Great. Great. It's always a challenge. Will you get back?
Did you buy these...
No, I imported them.
Wholesome Bickies?
Imported them from Victoria.
Don't want to put on any weight or anything. I've got to be careful with our weight.
Why is it suddenly our weight?
I thought you've got a bit of a little,
I've lost 13 kilograms, thank you.
13?
I know where they've gone, too.
Passive weight gain, that's what it is.
That well-known group of compares still in common.
Clive, what do you think ATN Channel 7, what are its main attributes?
It's not owned by Channel 9.
Yes.
Or the ABC.
Yes.
Or SBS.
But do you think if it was placed anywhere else in Australia, this station would be the same?
Yes.
And what about some of its big features, like facilities, some of the high-tech equipment here?
Apparently very good.
Yeah?
Just that we lost the instruction manual for some of it. Do you know who's ad-libbing all this?
You could never have guessed.
No. Five, is there anything...
Totally unprepared.
Unprofessional, unprepared.
But, you know, ATN Channel 7 is famous for its news. How do you feel about its news?
Gee, that's a collector's item. When was this? This is the golden years of television.
Oh, here's one now.
Five's taking a call, ladies and gentlemen.
Good evening.
Good evening. This is a lady from a company called Lineup who said she sent you a camera to have a look at.
Yeah, but she wants it back, does she?
No, she just wonders how you're going with it.
It's wonderful.
Does she talk, or why does she always talk in the third person?
I don't know. Katrina?
Yes?
Why don't you do, what do you think of Saturday Morning Live?
What do I think of Saturday Morning Live?
Apart from repeating
I've watched it, so I can't comment.
Great. Whoa. Another one of your satisfied viewers.
Thank you so much. What about the publicity department here at Channel 7?
The support that you've been
whether we should get one or not. I think it'd be a good idea. A lot of the other stations are going for that now. I think it's a great idea. If you'd like to audition for the publicity department, ring Channel 7 and speak to Ian.
So here we are in the newsroom. It's pretty exciting stuff.
Certainly.
Look, I'll just look, more news.
Hard-hitting news.
More news piling in from overseas. Oh, it's Home and Away. What do you think of Clive Robertson?
Great on radio.
Well, I think that pretty well wraps up the segment, doesn't it?
Clive,
John?
Is there anything you'd like to say to people out there in television land who are thinking about getting into the actual medium themselves?
Yes, I think you shouldn't.
Why not?
Because it's silly. Look at the people you have to work with.
Welcome back to Saturday Morning Live. I guess the best way to do this is just to hold it up. You know, the Australian rock and roll industry is full of rumours, if you haven't guessed already. One that we like concerns our next guest early in his career, who was thrown out of a band because he wore purple flares. Later, he was signed by another band for exactly the same reason. Please welcome the man who's legendary for his noisy sax, Joe Camilleri from The Black Sorrow. Yeah. Welcome to the show. Was it true that whole thing about the purple flares?
Yeah, that was quite true. I just joined Adderley Smith Blues Band, and we played Dallas Brooks Hall, and I was about a week into the band, and they did this big show, and they had all these blues fanatics, and they kind of wrote a letter about the fact that I was giving blues a bad name.
Because they weren't actually flares,
you know. Well-tailored trousers.
What about noisy sax? Are you into noisy sax?
I like a little bit of noisy sax.
Well, you haven't noticed.
You actually played with a few other people, like Screaming Joe Hawkins.
Yeah, I did a tour in Australia.
Ice House.
The Ice House. Yeah.
What's it like as a hotshot producer in your own right, Lick Lick Smum Smum, and also having your own band of very very distinguished musicians?
They're loving it now. Just keep laying it on.
How is it like? What's it like actually? You know, being suddenly a player in a band and playing for someone like Ice House?
Well, it was a relief, really. Because you've got no grief. And
good money?
Yeah, and it was incredibly good money.
Does it make you treat your own band better, you think, after those experiences?
I always treat my band with an incredible amount of respect.
Is that true, guys? Yeah. Yeah, they're nodding.
They're very happy. They're here. You know.
They're making funny things with their hands. I like Victory, I think it was. Victory to
The new album, it's a double album.
Well, it's a bonus.
It's a bonus.
An album record with a bonus.
Yeah, exactly.
So there's two records for the first 10,000 or something.
It's called
5,000, whatever.
It's called
Hold On To Me.
Hold On To Me
with some noisy sax.
And the single, I believe, was released yesterday?
I think it was yesterday.
We thought we were going to play the new clip, but we thought, you know, all the rock shows and all the clip shows say, get the new clip in there quite. We thought, why not get the guys in live, wake them up early.
That's right.
Get them some national television, and next week we're going to play the clip as well, so it's sort of like a double wedge.
Plus you're doing a sort of country and western sort of thing.
Well, the hat's beautiful. It's fabulous. But I think you should give me this.
Talk to him about it. It's just But I mean, speaking of country and western, I mean, you've been through so many different styles of music. I mean, there was Zydeco, phase you went through. I mean, is it, you've always had a lot of music credibility to me anyway. I mean, do you like doing different, but do you like doing different styles of music? And I mean, it's good to see you haven't sort of been.
I don't know. I think it all evolves into one. Yeah. I don't sort of go out to say, oh, well, I'm going to go and do something with this. I come across Zydeco music when I reformed the Sorrows just out of chance, really, because I had a piano accordion player and a violin player.
What's happened to the piano accordion?
Well, he kind of got
other
work.
He's playing with Ice House now, isn't he?
Yeah, he's probably doing... he's got his own band now called the Zydeco Playboys. Mm. But he...
He does other things as well.
You should explain to people around Australia who maybe don't know what Zydeco is. What kind of music would you sort of explain?
I haven't got the faintest idea.
It's kind of
it's country. It's really country music, really. And it's just because it was the Cajuns used it a lot, and they used quick step.
That's because the Cajun cooking, of course, is very, very hot peppers and a lot of cayenne pepper. So you have some of that, and then you really want to get into some fast music real quick.
It's good. It's good dance music. Really, and but they just kind of work on the blues and
you have some blues. You have some new backing vocalists.
Yeah, I've got Vicar and Linda Bull, two fine singers their own right.
They do some serious dancing.
Yeah, choreography, that's the word.
Well, look, we're going to ask you to join the band so you can do Country Girls.
Can I just do one final plug?
Certainly.
Hold On To Me is the album. It'll be out beginning of September. No, late September, I think.
Yeah, mid-September.
Joe, would you like to go over and join the Sorrows
The single's
now.
Out now.
Hold On To Me. Next week we'll be showing the single. What we thought, what the heck?
We keep that country vibe going,
don't we? We've got a tiny budget, but we thought, let's try and get them in here live. They're going to be singing a song called Country Girls, which was co-written by a very lovely guy, Jeff Burston, who's also a Sorrow. He's over there with the glasses.
You'll see him. He's in the white shirt in
white
the band.
Shirt.
Watch out for
acoustic
Jeff.
Guitar.
And right now, here they are, Joe Camilleri and the Black Sorrows and Country Girls.
From the Rio Grande.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, family pets, that just about wraps it up for another Saturday Morning Live because we've run out of money.
Thanks very much to Joe Camilleri and the Black Sorrows. Don't forget the new singles in your stores at the moment. It's called Hold On To Me. The album's out in September. It's fantastic stuff. Thanks for being on the program, folks.
And next week we'll be showing the single, but we've also got some fabulous talent coming in. We've got the whole of the Mormon Tabernacle Choir,
Ernie Sigley,
the Monkees, maybe.
A number of other people. It should be fantastic.
1927 are coming in live, and also Grant Kenny, the guy with all the muscles. So, girls, make sure you're watching, won't you? Thank you very much. Don't forget you can see the Black Sorrows touring around Australia.
They start very shortly. Very shortly.
We're doing it.
Virtually now. As we speak,
I'll be getting my hat back from Joe, but in the meantime, why don't you join us for a couple of bars of Old Cowhand?
We'll see you next week. Godfathers and Cockfight
Mentor. Old Cowhand. From the Rio.